Let's take a look at using On1 Photo RAW 2024. Can it edit infrared images? Yes. In fact, I've created an infrared preset collection to speed up your editing with On1 Photo RAW. Is this the right RAW editor for you? Let's cover some basics, edit an infrared image, and check out the infrared preset collection. On1 Photo RAW 2024 is available as a standalone Mac or Windows app for a one-time price. It is also available as a subscription that includes plugins and cloud storage. There are also mobile apps for iPhone, iPad, and Android. When using cloud storage, your edits are shared between the desktop and mobile versions. Unfortunately, some of the key features needed for infrared editing are not yet supported by the mobile apps. Let's do a quick edit of an infrared image with On1. First, let's set a white balance. So on the right-hand column in On1, I'll go to the Develop tab. From here, I'll go down to Tone and Color. In the Tone and Color section, I want to select Color. And this is where I can set my white balance. Let's talk a little bit about the white balance controls. We have a picker we can use to select the portion of the image that we want to set a white balance on. There's a little K Kelvin button here over here, and this is really important. Let's talk about that in a little bit, why that's important. And then, of course, we have our temperature and tint sliders. So let me grab the picker. I will point to the white clouds in my image. And what we'll notice is that we didn't get a great white balance. And that's because the temperature slider has a range of 2000 Kelvin to 50,000 Kelvin. And that's just not going to cut it for infrared. But what we can do is we can use this K button to disable the Kelvin settings. And instead of having a range of 2000 to 50,000 Kelvins, we'll instead have a range of negative 400 to 400. And so using that, we should be able to set a good white balance. So make sure that this K button is disabled. It's enabled when it's bold. We want it to be disabled so that it's not bold. Now I can select the eyedropper, then go to my clouds and select a white balance. And there we go. Now I have a nice white balance. You can see I have a nice blue color in the foliage here. And there's a bit of a gold color in the sky. I've got a nice separation. My clouds are white. The neutrals in this image, the ground, the building are neutral. Now I have a great white balance. So just be aware that when you're setting a white balance, you may need to disable the Kelvin option in order to set a good white balance. Now let's make some adjustments to the tone and structure of the image. So we'll go into tone here in tone and color. This is a little underexposed, so I'm going to bring up the exposure. I'm looking at my histogram up here to get a feel for what a good exposure is. I want a nice balance in the middle here that's not too far to the highlights and too much into the shadows, but gives me a nice balance. I can look at my histogram and look at my image to find a good exposure. I can also set my contrast. I could adjust highlights here, increase and lower highlights. Maybe we'll bring up the midtones a little bit, bring up the shadows, drop the blacks. So I can make all the adjustments that I would like here in tone. I can go down into structure, and this gives me the ability to add some mid-range contrast, much like clarity, say, in Lightroom. So I can drag the structure and give me a little bit more of that mid-range contrast. I could also use haze to decrease haze in the sky, which of course is going to add a lot of really harsh contrast, or I could go in the reverse even, but I'll just add a hint of dehaze here. Now let's talk about swapping colors. We have four different ways to swap colors here in On1. So the first method is the channel mixer. We're going to go into the effects tab here on the right, and I will select add filter. Once I've done that, I'll get my menu of available filters, and I will select channel mixer. So the channel mixer allows us to swap the red and the blue channels and even play with the green channel if we like. Right out of the box, On1 has a style or a preset called IR Swap. So let's just click that and see what happens. So there we go. We've got a quick swap of our colors. We have a nice color in the hedge here, and then we have a little bit of a teal color in the sky. So that is one way that we can adjust our colors. But let's say that I wanted to make an adjustment to the green channel. All this IR swap did was swap the reds and the blues. So I could come down here and select the green channel. And then the green channel, let's say I want to split that and make it 50 in the red, 0 in the green, and 50 in the blue. There we go. Now I have a much more realistic sky and a different color in the bush here. Let's say I wanted to apply that style to multiple images, but I don't want to repeat those steps for every image. That's easy to do. I can select the More dropdown here in the Styles area and save a new style. Now I can type in the name of the style. This was IR swap was the original, plus I added a green split. So I'll just say green split and then save. And now I can see if I go into the More menu, that's now available as a preset. If I was to delete the channel mixer, add a new filter, select channel mixer, and now this is available and I can jump right in and grab that. So these styles are a great way to apply your settings quickly. All right, let's delete my channel mixer and we'll move on to the second method of swapping colors in On One. This is going to be the invert method, and to do that, we're going to use curves. So I will select add a filter and we will go to curves. In curves, what we want to do is invert the curve so that all of the colors are swapped. And we'll do that under styles. We'll take a pre-selection of invert, which is already done for us. The blend mode needs to change. We can do that here under the gear, select the gear and go under blending and change the blend mode from normal to either hue or color. And either hue or color will give us the blend mode we need. And we can also do the same thing here. If we want to save this as a style, we could go into the style menu and we could say, create a new style. We could call this IR invert. And now I've created a new style. And now I can very easily replicate the invert method in On One. All right, let's delete the curves effect and talk about our third way to swap colors in On One. If I add a filter and go down to LUTs, then I can use LUTs to do color swaps. You can create your own LUTs, or you can download the LUTs that I have available on my website. Links are in the description, and you can apply those here in On One. I have already imported those LUTs, and if I go down into the category, you can see that there's two categories I've imported here, infrared color swap and infrared creative. Let's look at color swap, and this will show me a variety of methods from a hue adjustment to an invert, a swap, a red-blue swap with a green split, and then shifting the green channel either to blue or red. And so you could use those, any of those LUTs, to swap your colors. Also, there's a number of creative LUTs that are available, and so you could walk through any of those and see what kind of style those apply to your image and give those a try. So LUTs are another great way to swap colors within On One. All right, let's delete the LUTs effect and talk about the fourth way to swap colors with On One. And in this case, I'll be using my new presets, infrared presets for On One. So if we go over to the left-hand panel under presets and scroll down, we can see infrared. So there's the infrared group. And within the infrared group, we have a variety of options for swapping colors. We have five different color treatments: gold, invert, pink, split, and swap. And then we have six different monochrome treatments. So you could pick the color or monochrome treatment that you like. So for example, let's try gold. So we'll go into gold. Once we're in gold, and within any category, the first option is basically the color swap itself, just the plain color swap with no other effects. But in addition to that, there's a variety of other effects that you can apply for each color or monochrome treatment. So for all of the color treatments, there's 12 different looks that you can apply. And so you can see a variety of them here, and you could pick any of these you like. So if you're looking for a really quick way to edit your infrared images, you could use these presets to both swap colors and apply an effect at the same time. This variety of looks covers a whole variety of subjects. In this particular case, maybe this gold mid look looks good with what's here, but there may be other cases where a flat look is more appropriate or something with a bit of a glow is more appropriate. So you can pick the style that you like for your image. Let's look at a few of these others. We'll go into invert. First option gives you the treatment, and then there's a whole variety of styles and effects that you can get from these different presets. You can see this is a very quick way to apply one of these looks to an infrared image once you've set a white balance. So set a white balance first and then apply a preset. So you've got all these options available. In addition to that, there are the monochrome options. So there are six different monochrome treatments that apply a different tonality based on the colors in your image. And then within each of these, there are 10 styles that you can look at. There's the monochrome treatment only. There are a number of different looks to suit whatever is appropriate for your particular image. And if I go to a different monochrome look, then there's a different treatment for the sky, a different treatment for foliage. They'll vary slightly within each of the monochrome looks. So you can pick the monochrome look that works best for your image and then apply the effect that works for you. In addition to the color and monochrome treatments, there are also a local contrast. And what local contrast does is it uses the adaptive AI within On One to apply contrast to the sky, foliage, foreground, a variety of elements. And there's four different intensities of contrast. So if I click on contrast 4, then On One will apply the contrast to different elements within the image. And you can see that by looking at the local tab over here on the right, where I can see that I have a natural ground. On One has identified where the natural ground is and an applied a contrast effect there. It's decided where the flora is and it's decided where the sky is. And it will do this separately for each image. So you don't need to be masking these out. You can automatically have On One adapt to your image and then apply these effects. So these effects are a great way to very quickly process your infrared images. Let's take a separate infrared image and walk through how quickly it is to edit within On One. So the first thing that I'll do is I'll come over to the tone and color area. I'm going to adjust my tones a little bit. So bring up the exposure a little bit and add some contrast. The next thing that I'll do is I'll come over to the left here under crop, and I want to crop and do a little bit of a rotation on this image. So we'll crop in a little bit on the left-hand side here. And then I will rotate. I'm just clicking outside the image and rotating to level the building in the background there. So we'll get that level. I can click this blue checkbox to accept the crop that I've made. So now I can set my white balance. I'll go into color. I'll select the eyedropper, click on the pavement in this image. Okay, so I've gotten my white balance adjustment. The white balance actually looks pretty good. I'm going to go back into tone though and make some adjustments to the tone now that I've got my white balance set, get my exposure set a little bit. You could make other adjustments to the highlights and get the image just where you need it to be. Okay, so I've got some good adjustments there, maybe a little bit more contrast and a little bit of structure we'll throw into this image. Okay, so now I want to swap colors and I can come down to the infrared group. First thing I want to do is pick the color treatment that I'm looking at. So basically I can look at these tabs to get a feel for the general color that I'm going to be looking at. This is also a 590 nanometer image, but the same would apply with a 550 nanometer image, 665, 720. The only thing those filters will do is impact the amount of color saturation that you have, but otherwise the color effects will be similar. So let's say I want to do pink on this one. I can look through the variety of treatments that are available here that will give me the look I want. I think that probably this mid look or maybe the strong look will look good with this building, give me a lot of contrast in the building. The strong look, punch, and mid all have really nice contrast for a structure like this. So let's go with the strong look. And so there we go. So I have made all of my adjustments, set a white balance, and then I've applied a preset to very quickly swap colors and add some effects to the image. And that's really all there is to it. If you prefer to minimize the time spent editing your images, if you don't need to edit on a mobile device, or if you don't like software subscriptions, this could be the RAW editor for you. On One Photo RAW offers a 30-day trial, so you can give it a spin. It's available as a standalone app or via monthly subscription on Mac and Windows. Do you use On One for processing your infrared images? What do you like or dislike about it? Let us know in the comments. If you'd like to learn more about infrared photography, subscribe to my newsletter. A link is in the description. If you find these videos helpful on your infrared photography journey, like, subscribe, or comment. Hope you enjoyed. Thanks.